U.S. Army, Navy, and Air Force first common operational hypersonic weapons system. The U.S. Air Force, Army, and Navy are pooling their efforts on a common unpowered boost glide vehicle design that could help give each one of them an operational hypersonic weapon in the near term. Aviation Week detailed the Pentagon's latest efforts to combine the Air Force's Hypersonic Conventional Strike Weapon, HCSW, the Army's Advanced Hypersonic Weapon, AHW, and the Navy's Conventional Prompt Strike, CPS, programs into a single effort in a story on October 11, 2018. The goal of this tri-service plan is to be able to field a complete weapon, capable of flying more than 6 times the speed of sound, by 2021. "We each have pieces of programs," said the U.S. Air Force Secretary Heather Wilson at a forum the Washington Post hosted in May 2018. "The Army's warhead had worked much better than the Air Force's. So we're going to take the Army warhead, put it on an Air Force booster, launch it off of a B-52, while the Army is developing on the ground and the Navy wants to put it on the deck of a ship. The idea is about just taking the fastest path to the goal line with the technology that exists. Since the Navy faces the most challenges in developing a weapon that a missile submarine will be able to fire, it is in charge of developing the boost glide vehicle itself," according to Aviation Week. On October 1, 2018, the service awarded a contract worth more than $13 million to the Charles Stark Draper Laboratory in Massachusetts to support that work. The vehicle itself is a conical design made of a composite of metals and other materials, including carbon fiber, which is derived from the one the Army had been developing for the AHW program. Given this experience, the Army and Navy will be produce and responsible for flight testing them, sources told Aviation Week. Each of the 3 services involved in the program will use their own boosters for ground, air, and submarine launched applications. There remain few details about the exact size and capabilities of the new boost glide vehicle. Swerve was approximately 100 inches long and could reach a peak of Mach 12 before gliding along at a sustained Mach 8 for a full minute. The Army's goal for AHW was also a sustained speed of around 8 times the speed of sound that would allow the weapon to travel around 3,700 miles in just 35 minutes. The Pentagon had initially treated AHW as a less risky, more mature backup to the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency's DARPA, more ambitious force application and launch from Continental United States program, or Falcon. That project used half-cone boost glide vehicle designs known as hypersonic test vehicles, HTV, that held the promise of being faster, more maneuverable, and more accurate. But while the Army's boost glide vehicle might have been less agile and potentially slower, it also worked, while DARPA's program struggles. "What has apparently changed the calculus is the rapid development of comparable hypersonic boost glide vehicles in Russia and China. The Russians plan to declare their nuclear-armed hypersonic boost glide vehicle, a Vanguard, operational in 2019. These threats have pushed AHW to the forefront of the Pentagon's hypersonic priorities, since it is most likely to result in viable, if imperfect, weapon system in the near future, according to Aviation Week. This has also prompted DARPA to begin a separate program, called Glide Breaker, to develop a means to counter incoming hypersonic threats. This would increase the flexibility of any powered hypersonic system. The IFA program could lead to engines to power future expendable air and surface launched weapons, as well as reusable platforms for intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance missions and long-range time-sensitive strikes. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.